tonight. There have been lots of fires in Moccasin Flats of late, and the air quality in the area has plummeted as a result. Plus, with the Cougars winning ways in the playoffs so far, we look at impacts of the run on local businesses. And it's graduation day for another batch of Northern BC doctors from UNBC's Northern Medical Program. Good evening, folks. I'm Eddie Huband, and welcome to CKPG News. Our top story tonight, the contentious issue of the homeless encampment in Moccasin Flats is heating up once again. There have been numerous complaints to the city recently about the encampment from those residents who live above it, and it will be discussed at length on Monday by council. This time, the complaints are due to the poor air quality in the area, which many believe is caused by the frequent fires in the encampment. Cheryl Jan reports in tonight's top story.
This is one more example of a fire near Moccasin Flats. It comes on the heels of a fire that erupted in late March. It prompted a letter to council at the most recent meeting about the toxic smoke that plagues the Miller Addition.
It's getting worse, and we need to definitely enforce some of the Health Safety Act. This is open fire, especially in complete combustible material that it's toxic, to anybody.
The letter cites a website that tracks air quality. It shows significantly higher levels of fine particulate matter in the Upper Patricia neighborhood than others.
So I think the concerns of the residents are absolutely valid. I have the same concerns. We're seeing toxic smoke come up the hill. That purple air meter that's stationed up on Upper Patricia has readings that are wild in comparison to any other meter around our city. Why is that? Well, the data correlates to when the encampment was established, and so that's concerning.
Many of the challenges that are occurring at the end of 4th Avenue are due to illegal dumping, and Mayor Simon Yu can only shake his head.
Ugliness attracts ugliness. And when there's a large amount of garbage, it's not being sorted out and just dumped there, and people will feel, well, that maybe it is a garbage dumping area, So things like that happens. So we need to do much, much better.
The question council now struggles with is how to deal with it.
How can we up our patrol or our presence, whether it's from fire or bylaw, to help reduce that risk of fire spread and toxic smoke? That's our responsibility, and those are some of the things I'm going to be looking at coming up with solutions on through this town hall, through the dialogue with staff and council, and in conjunction with our legal counsel to make sure we're within our rights.
A notice of motion by three city councilors to create a community safety town hall will be discussed at greater detail on Monday night. Cheryl Jan, CKPG News.
The Prince George Cougars have been on a tear this postseason. They're 7-1 so far, and they currently hold a 3-1 lead over the Kelowna Rockets in round two of the playoffs. We'll have more on that later on. But it's not just the team and the fans that are enjoying the success. Local businesses have also benefited big from the Cougars' dominance. Tommy Osborne brings us the details.
Since the WHL playoffs began, the CN Centre has sold out every game, leading to significantly higher revenue for the Prince George Cougars in terms of ticket and concession sales, alongside more merchandise sold too. While the Cougars' success obviously benefits them greatly both on and off the ice, the team isn't the only one enjoying the dominant playoff run, as restaurants and pubs all over the city have been a part of the excitement too.
I would say ballpark is probably about 60 to 70% more business, especially on Tuesday night, which is usually one of our slower nights. We've been packed on those away games for sure, and it's been excellent.
Our Winston's and our Shogun have definitely had an increase in dinner reservations before the games, as well as we've seen people come in after the game for a late night appy and nightcap.
The playoffs also means hotels have been getting booked up. In fact, at one point, the Coast Hotel was so full it couldn't even accommodate the Kelowna Rockets. While that wasn't purely because of the WHL playoffs, it certainly played a big role.
Since they've gone into the playoffs, we've seen a huge increase in our rooms occupied and our revenues. It's very good to see. That's from people coming in to support the Kelowna Rockets, as well as the outlying communities around Prince George has come in to support the Cougars.
When business is booming, it's great for the owners, but not just the owners, as it ends up putting extra cash in everyone's pockets. For example, with hotels, you need to hire more cleaning staff, while a busy pub or restaurant obviously needs more staff to help out.
We have to bring in, you know, a couple extra servers and extra staff to help out, and it, you know, it benefits everybody with, you know, getting more wages and more tips.
The Cougars' playoff success up to this point has left both the fans and our local businesses cheering. And with the playoff run expected to continue for at least a couple more weeks, it looks like our community will be able to continue to celebrate what has been a historically great Cougars season. Tommy Osborne, CKPG News.
It was graduation day today as the Northern Medical Program at UNBC produced another set of budding doctors. Two of the graduates we caught up with have aspirations to practice in the North as well. Cheryl Jan reporting once again.
It was a special day for the 17th graduating class from the Northern Medical Program. They'll all be getting the traditional white gown and shingle like hundreds of their predecessors, and their aspirations are high.
Yeah, so next year I'll be heading to Victoria. So I got into radiation oncology as my residency program. So I'll be heading towards Victoria, be there for the first year, kind of doing some general medicine. And then after that, I'll be doing 4 more years in Vancouver. And then hopefully after that, coming back and working at the cancer clinic here.
I'm going to be a family doctor, and I'm going back to my hometown of Smithers, actually, for training in a new program that UBC just got going called Rural Immersion. And that's a 2-year program.
The fact the medical school is so close to these young doctors' homes makes a huge plus.
Oh, having the Northern Medical Program really motivated me to want to join medicine and pursue medicine. I think that by having like my family supports around me, I was able to feel comfortable doing something that otherwise would feel maybe a bit uncomfortable. And so I was really grateful for this program that's here.
Yeah. And I left Smithers to come to the Northern Medical Program, well, UNBC, and then here. I wasn't that far from my family. I get to see them on weekends. I'm familiar with the North. Even when I was engaging in research and all that sort of thing, it's my home turf. I'm heavily invested here. I always plan to stay here.
Healthcare is in a state of staffing crisis right now, and the NMP will try its best to fill those gaps.
The healthcare HR issue, it's complex. Healthcare has become increasingly complex over the last 20, 30 years, and we can do more. The technology has increased, so I think we need more healthcare providers than ever. We're trying to fill that gap. It takes time. We have just expanded our class over the past 2 years in line with government announcements that you would have heard 2 years ago now.
So congratulations to these 33 new young doctors who convocate at the end of May. Cheryl Jan, CKPG News.
Premier David Eby says thousands of short-term rental units will soon go back to the long-term market as new rules will take effect on May 1st. He's warning real estate investors and speculators that BC is tilting the rules towards families seeking homes in the new tighter regulations. Eby made the remarks as the province announced new figures gathered last month that showed more than 19,000 entire homes listed as short-term rentals. He says the changes aren't a ban on platforms such as Airbnb, and homeowners may still list their primary residence as a short-term rental. The Amanika Arts Center is planning an exhibit to celebrate our local Indigenous artists and is looking for artists to submit their work to be featured. The exhibit will open in June to celebrate Indigenous Peoples Day, but submissions need to be in by April 30th. The theme is Ancestral Manifestations of Past, Present, and Future, and it's open to Indigenous artists of all ages, styles, and styles of art. Whether it's painting, beadwork, music, dance, or anything really, the Amanika Arts Center hopes to feature your work. Amanika added, beyond the chance to be featured, there will be other opportunities for artists who are part of the exhibit to make use of the platform that Amanika has, as the Arts Center wants to do whatever it can to promote our local artists.
If any of the artists would like to run workshops or come in and do open hours throughout the month, so spend a few hours here using the space as their studio if they need a larger space to do a painting or something. And then the exhibition reception is usually in the evening, so one of the evenings during the month we'll celebrate and have food and drinks and just opportunities for the artists to speak about their work and their process, maybe some of their history and their ancestry. What I've also seen is the artists connecting with each other and coming up with projects and maybe doing group exhibitions themselves, even just a group exhibition of two people would work.
As of this morning, the lowest gas price in Prince George was sitting at $1.649 per litre at Costco. That also happens to be the lowest price in the province right now. Manitoba currently has the lowest fuel prices on average in the country at $1.424 per liter, while BC has an average price of $1.957 per liter.
CKPG Sports is delivered by Domino's. Try one of our delicious stuffed cheesy breads, paired up with chicken, pizza, pasta, or dessert for just $8.99 per item.
The Prince George Cougars tried to pull off their second sweep of the WHL playoffs last night when they faced the Kelowna Rockets in Game 4, but they didn't have enough in opposing territory against a goalie who loves to play in his home rink. Here is last night's highlights.
Cougars Rockets Game 4 at Prospera Place. Both teams exchanging quality chances early on, but goaltenders Yari Kekkonen and Ty Young are up to the task as we head to the second period scoreless. In that middle frame, the Cougars with a gorgeous chance to break the tie, but Yari Kekkonen says no multiple times to the scramble in front. Then moments later, it's a 2-on-1 for PG, but Tarek Parasak can't put it home, which would lead to the first goal of the evening on the other side as Max Graham throws it in front and it deflects off a Cougars stick and past Ty Young. Prince George trails 1-0. And it wouldn't stop there as Gabriel Stooch would find himself a shooting lane just 4 minutes later. That goal coming in the last minute of the second period, and Kelowna leads 2-0 with 20 minutes to go. Once again, the Cougars would press, and once again, the puck luck wouldn't be there. First, it's Borja Vallis missing the net. Then it's Riley Height stoned by Kekkonen. Then it's Tarek Parasak having the puck go past the yawning cage. It would take until the 16:37 mark for Hudson Thornton to finally find the back of the net, dicing the lead in half and increasing the drama. Unfortunately, that's all the Cougars could muster up. The Kelowna Rockets stave off elimination and force a Game 5. The silver lining is tickets are hot to get into the CN Center in what is once again expected to be a sold-out crowd for Friday night.
The TSX is up 52 points to close at 21,708. The Dow Jones is up 22 points to close at 37,775. And CN Rail went up 18 cents to close at $175.11.
CKPG Sports is delivered by Domino's. Try one of our delicious stuffed cheesy breads, paired up with chicken, pizza, pasta, or dessert for just $8.99 per item.
There's certainly some exciting news when Quesnel announced they were rewarded with the junior hockey team, the third expansion team to join the Kootenai International Junior Hockey League. Now the preparation begins for next season. Anthony Correa has more on the River Rush.
The West Fraser Center, home of the newest expansion team in the Kootenai International Junior Hockey League, the Quesnel River Rush. The first time Quesnel has had junior hockey in the city since 2011.
Well, super excited. Been trying for years to get a team here. It finally all come together and looking forward to it.
Tracy Merrill will take the reins as the new owner and president after he bought and relocated the North Okanagan Knights franchise to the city of Quesnel. Merrill, who has previously been the principal owner of the Kamloops Storm since 2019, always wanted to bring a locally owned Junior A hockey team back to the city.
The big desire was there's so many local kids that have come from Quesnel that have gone and played elsewhere, so it's a chance for them to stay at home and play and show their talent instead of moving out of town at an early age.
With the KIJHL thrilled to expand their league this offseason, adding three different teams, though it wasn't the first time the league had tried expanding up north.
This was, I think, the third attempt to bring a team to Quesnel in the KIJHL. There was some interest back in the late 2010s, pre-COVID. There was a bit of interest coming out of COVID, and then things really got going in November and December of last year and led up to the announcement that you heard a couple weeks ago.
A big selling factor to everyone involved was the West Fraser Center, a rink that was built in 2017 and holds 1,300 fans, one of the nicest junior hockey rinks in all of the KIJHL.
We got a brand new facility here. You know, it's about as good as you're going to get, I think, for the size of city that we got. And when we were working on getting the arena, we were kind of expecting a junior team to come.
One of the first things on the River Rush's agenda was partnering with the Letako Dene Nation.
Tracy approached us right off the bat when he found out that this was going to happen, and we were super excited when he did so. We're going to be sponsoring center ice for the year, and we're also going to be in charge of the Indigenous third jersey for the team. So, I mean, what an honor.
With the nation also being a big part in choosing the name, the River Rush.
We wanted to make sure that the river was incorporated. Lataco means where the three rivers meet is actually the name of Lataco, so that's where that comes from.
Season tickets and even merchandise are expected to be available to fans as soon as next week, with training camp expected to open up in early August. It's no secret that the city of Quesnel is excited to have junior hockey back. Anthony Correa in Quesnel, CKPG News.
A name many Cougars fans know and love is former goaltender Taylor Gauthier, who was recently named ECHL Goaltender of the Year. Gauthier, who plays for the Wheeling Nailers, went 24-16-2 in 42 appearances this season. He led all goaltenders with a .923 save percentage, shared the lead with four shutouts, was fourth in wins, and second with a 2.23 goals against average. He allowed two goals or less in 23 of his 42 appearances, and he was named ECHL Goalie of the Week four times, tied for most in a single season in league history. Gauthier spent five seasons with the Cats and sits fifth all-time in Cougars wins with 53. And having a good goalie in the NHL is crucial, as you may know. They can steal games from teams by just a single performance. Well, that was the case in Dallas last night. You'll see what I mean in tonight's CKP3.
We start with a final goodbye in Arizona.
Roll the fill with you here. You're obviously hockey royalty. Here's a breakaway.
Pacelli, backhander score. 2-1 Arizona. Looking like a 1999 version of the guy to my right.
One of five Coyotes to score in their final game. Now it's off to Salt Lake City, Utah. Next, Otters can jump.
Here's Thomas, moves in, doesn't shoot. Back out, Perunovic, a diving save by Ottinger to rob Perunovic of what would have been his first National Hockey League goal.
Jake Ottinger out of position, but the Stars goalie dives in desperation to rob the St. Louis Blues of a goal. But he wasn't done there.
Pass across for Thomas off the post. Now Stan Colvin chasing after the puck, draws a penalty.
This one was in overtime. Ottinger reaches back with his stick to get a piece of Robert Thomas's shot. All that plus making three saves to win the game in the shootout as Jake Ottinger takes top spot in tonight's CKP3.
That's all for tonight, folks. Thanks for joining us as always. And your last look this evening is a great one. It's if you look closely, you can see three little bear cubs working away on the top of that tree. Awesome stuff. It's a good sign of spring. Have a good night, folks. We'll see you later.